Hi, I'm Bob Thomas, and I'm here today with a couple of items from Studiomaster, that great little British company that makes really good value for money PA for the working band. It's well made, it sounds great, it's rugged on the road, and it seems to last forever and a day. What we've got today is their Vision 1008 stereo powered mixer and the Drive 112 speaker cabinet, passive speaker cabinet, that goes very well with the Vision, as you'll see. The Vision itself, there are three in the range. There's Vision 8, which is the unpowered version, just the mixer section. You've got this one, the Vision 1008, Vision 1008, which has got two 500 watt Class D amplifiers. And you've got the Vision 2008, or 2008, which, as the name implies, has got two 1000 watt Class D amplifiers. Having Class D amplifiers is great because it means that you don't have to have loudspeakers connected. Class D amplifiers are self-protecting by design. So if you're in a situation where, let's say you turn up at a club and it's got a installed PA system, you don't have to use your amplifiers. You can just go straight out to the club's PA system. In those kind of situations, you can also use the amplifiers to drive from the monitor channels, and we'll talk about that in some detail in a minute. As I said, construction-wise, Studiomaster gear is well built. The Vision, steel, wooden end cheeks. And the wooden end cheeks look to me like bamboo, although I'm no expert, but what I am an expert in is picking things up. And these have got molded hand grips underneath, so you can slip your fingers underneath it when it's sitting on a desk surface and pick it up really, really easily. If you need to rack mount it, and many people do these days, then the Vision comes with rack mounts included, so you can put it in a flight case for greater protection. It's got six mic line input channels. Microphones have got switchable phantom power, it's global, so it's either on or off on all six. Fairly standard channel, high pass filter, gain, EQ, effect sends, monitor, pan, mute and PFL. Again, we can look at all these in some detail later on. Two stereo inputs, RCA and jack, and those have got an identical channel. The only difference being that instead of having the high pass filter of the mic channels, it's got a switch that selects the input to these channels from either the RCAs and jacks or from the USB sockets. Comprehensive I/O, you've got all the connections that we'll need up there. A 9-band graphic equalizer, that's all at the usual frequencies, from 63 Hz to 16K. Some nice, very practical amplifier switching, which we'll talk about in a minute. Twin DSPs, reverb and delay on each one, and they're identical, so you can mix and match as you like. And they've got quite a comprehensive routing that we'll talk about. Record and playback from the connectors up here, headphone socket, and faders for your auxiliary monitor, DSP returns, and the main mixer. So the Drive 12, it's a 112 and horn cabinet, crossover at 2 kHz. Handles 500 watt program and 1000 watt peak, so it matches very, very well to the Vision 1008's power output. Composite cab, really good and sturdy. It's got flying points, a couple of handles on either side, so you can either fly it, or if you're carrying it around, it's really easy to carry. Like the Vision, its input is on speak-on connectors, because it's a passive speaker, obviously. And you've got these four-pole locking speaker connectors nowadays. There's a stand top hat underneath, so you can mount it on a speaker stand as normal as well. Great sounding speaker. Light to carry, but enough weight to give you confidence. A very good partner to the Vision 1008. So, let's take a look at the Vision 1008 in a little bit more detail. Right, let's take a closer look at the microphone and line input channel. First of all, you've got a balanced XLR connector for the microphone. This is phantom powered. There's a global phantom power switch over by the meters there. And that just turns power on and off globally for the six channels. Next down, there's the jack input for the line level input. This is followed by a high pass filter switch. This takes off all the rumble below 80 Hz, keeps things nice and quiet from handling noise. Then there's the channel gain switch, which matches the input level to the channel. Down at the bottom, there's a signal present light and a peak. So what you want is the signal present light lit all the time and the peak flashing, if at all, very occasionally. Next, you've got a three band EQ, followed by two aux sends. Now, the first send, DSP1, is routed permanently to the first onboard DSP processor. The second one is marked DSP2 aux, and that can be sent either to the second onboard DSP processor or to the aux output. There's a switch that selects this over there, and we'll look at that when we come to it. There's also then the monitor send, and the monitor feeds the monitor output up there directly. So you can set up two monitor mixes using the aux and the monitor, or you can have two DSP effects running at once and a monitor mix going out to your powered wedges. Then you've got a left-right pan, because as we mentioned earlier, this is stereo, so you've got a left-right pan. And then on each channel, you've got a mute switch, which is going to indicate a light, and a PFL switch, so you can listen to it before fade on your headphones. Finally, you've got the channel fader, a short throw fader that feels really nice and smooth. That's the microphone channel. Next, along at the end, we've got the two stereo input channels. They're left and right on either a quarter inch jack or RCA connectors. These don't have a low pass filter, or high pass filter. These don't have a high pass filter. These switches here select the input between the connectors at the top of the channel or the USB inputs over there. USB 1 and 2, USB 1, USB 2. The USB inputs, they're designed for replay from a computer or for sending a record signal to a computer. We'll talk about those in more detail in a second. Again, like the microphone channels, you have gain control, three band EQ, two DSP sends, one of which can be switched to an aux send to go to the external aux output instead of the DSP, a monitor output, and in this case it's called a balance control. You're just leveling up the input between left and right, and the same thing, a mute and a PFL and a fader. Next, we'll take a look at the I/O at the top end of the mixer, up here in this section here. We've already mentioned the USB 1 and USB 2 inputs and outputs. So USB 1 is sent to channel 7 and 8 via the USB 1 line level switch, and USB 2 to 9 and 10 via that switch there. When you're recording on your computer through these outputs, when using these as outputs, USB 1 records the output of the main mix, and USB 2 records the output of the mix between aux and monitor. So you can set up two separate recording mixes should you so desire. Up here, you've got a foot switch, which switches off the effects, because you obviously don't want reverb and delay running when if you're trying to make an announcement. And you've got a main mix mono output, which you could use to feed another powered speaker, to feed, say, another area of a restaurant or a hall. So you can send it to the bar if you've got a separate bar in your hall. Here you've got replay inputs on phono and mini jack, and you've got record outs on phono, so you can record an external recorder, external two-channel recorder. The main outputs from the mixer, not from the power amplifier, but from the mixer, come out on XLR, and you can also insert through the inserts. You can have a compressor or limiter, say, for example, sitting across the outputs so that the signal going to the power amplifier is kept down in a case where you don't want to be overdriving everything and you want to use a compressor to hold the sound down. Next section is the 9-band graphic equalizer. This runs at all the usual frequencies, 63, 125, 250, 500, 1K, 2K, 4K, 8K, 16K. So it covers the entire audio spectrum. And again, you can use these to tune your PA to the room. You may have a room that, say, is bass heavy. You might want to roll off a lot of bass on the room and perhaps boost the mid-range a bit. But you don't want to make it too trebly, so you pull the treble down. So you might get a shape like that, or you could, in some cases, if you want to have a sort of scoot mid-range because the room is quite midi, but there's not great in the bass or the treble, you'd have that kind of graph. It all depends on the room. Next to it, underneath the phantom power switch, you'll see two very interesting switches. One is the amplifier assign. This is, as we mentioned earlier, the Vision 1008 is a stereo power mixer, so you get two separate amplifiers. In the uppermost position, the inputs to the power amplifier are being fed from the left and right main outputs. In the second one down, you have the right-hand side of the amplifiers being fed by a mono mixed signal of the main outputs, and the left side being fed by the monitor output. And the bottom position, you've got the right-hand side of the mixer power amplifiers being fed by the aux output, and the left by the monitor output. Now, the reason for this is, obviously, in normal use of a small compact PA system, you're feeding left and right. If you've got a situation where you want to feed two speakers plus a monitor from the power amplifiers, then you can have your main mix going out to your two speakers and drive that from the right-hand side, and then drive your passive monitor wedge from the left-hand side. In the bottom position, you might be in a situation where you've got a house PA, so you're feeding the house PA from the left and right mix out of your mixer, and you're feeding your own monitors from the aux and monitor mixes. Next down is the amp power switch. This lets you switch the amplifier's power from 100% to 40% to 15% of rated output. So you can use this to control the maximum level that you'll hear from your amplifier. The next section is the DSPs. There are two, DSP1 and DSP2. They are identical. They have either reverbs or delays. So you can have either switching between them. So you could have one set on, as I think we've got here, one set on reverb, the other set on delay. The orange top buttons select the effect you're going to be using. And these two blue buttons here would relate to the monitors. So these are where you can send the output of the DSP sections to the monitors, so that perhaps your singer might like to hear himself with or herself with reverb and delay on her voice or his voice. Down here, you'll see a further two switches. The first one is the DSP2 aux switch, which sets the takeoff point for that either pre or post fade. Now, if you're using the DSP2 send, that one there, that bottom one there, if you're using that to feed the DSP section, you want to use it post fade because you want to set the level of the effect to the level going out on the mix. If you're using it as a monitor, you're using it as the aux send, then you switch it to pre-fade, and that keeps the level mixed from there constant no matter what happens on the faders. Finally, we've got a little set of switches here. The record level refers to the level going out on the record line, and the RCA is up there. The playback level sets a level coming in from the mini jack, or the RCA is there. You've got a mute button for it, for the playback. You've got a PFL for the playback, and you've got the standby switch. Now, what the standby switch is, it switches off the main outputs, or in fact, all the outputs on the desk, but it doesn't switch off the playback level. So if you want to do interval music, but you want to leave your PA up and running so you can just walk straight back up to it, then all you do is hit the standby switch. The PA is effectively switched off, but the interval music is still running through the playback level. And finally, you've got a set of headphones to monitor the PFLs, etc. Down at the bottom in the fader section, just to complete the package, you've got the output levels for the aux and monitor, which, if you're using this as foldback, would be your foldback levels. You've got the DSP returns level, so that's the output of the DSP section coming back to the main PA, or on those faders, and that's the main PA output level. Finally, round the back, there just happens to be two speak on connectors, left and right, a power switch and a reset button. And that is the Studiomaster Vision 1008.